From our previous tutorial, we are now aware of how to create a flexbox element. Now in this tutorial, we are going to understand how to create these margins. That means we are going to add some margins here. This is the final product that we are going to create in this tutorial. Now this is in actuality the product that we are about to transform into this final demonstration. Another thing, if we want to create something like this with the aid of normal CSS that we are aware of, in doing so, the first thing that we have done, we have created a mother wrapper, and we can see that the width of this box is practically 1000 pixels. Now inside this mother wrapper, we have created this all these things. This is the extreme left box that is going to reside in the extreme left end of your page. This is the middle box where we have provided some of these margins over here, such that they keep a constant margin from both the ends, from the left box and from the right box. And here goes another extreme right box that will be floating right. And in doing so, the syntax that we have used here is the floating condition. That means with the aid of floating condition, we have prepared all these three div elements, all these three boxes. And with the aid of clear fix option in the middle, we have maintained this particular margin from extreme right box and from extreme left box. So this is the thing that we have prepared with the aid of our normal CSS approach. But what about if we use some kind of display flex option? We will be using flexbox, and with the usage of this flexbox, we will be creating this thing. In this purpose, we have created another mother wrapper, which is known as motherbox11. And we can see that in this purpose, we haven't used any kind of width property over here. Now, if we come back to our project, we can see that this is the display wrapper, the mother wrapper that is wrapping all of these contents inside it. So this is being the parent wrapper here. This is being the parent div. All we are going to do, we are going to use the same term that we have used previously. That means this display flex option. As we have used this display flex option, now if we reload, we can see that all these things, all those contents, those are practically now getting horizontal in nature, and they are coming side by side. Now, if we do not provide any kind of this such element, such as this flex one or this kind of element, that means by default, the flex value is one. That means all of these boxes, they are practically of equal size. Now, in a particular case, we are just adding justify content flex start. In this particular case, all we have to do, first of all, we have to create this attribute. We have to use this attribute here, which is known as flex basis, and we are providing it as 30%. Now flex basis is practically a replacement of width property. Flex basis practically denotes a particular length of a block element. So you are rectifying, you are stating that 30% is the flex basis. Now, if we use a flat 30% all along, now if we use a 30% all along, now we can see, if we reload, that this is with the usage of this justify content as flex start, it is practically getting started from the extreme left position. Now, instead of using flex start, if we use flex end, then these contents will be starting from the extreme end position. Instead of using flex end, if we use here center, reload, and your contents will be aligned into the center. That means you have specified the flex basis here first, you have specified the length, and now you are specifying from where your contents should be started, whether it is from the extreme left or from the middle or from the end position of your parent div. Now all you want that all these three individual blocks or elements, those will be equally spaced from each other, and this is the prime concern that you are focusing on. So all we need to do, we need to provide a certain property which is known as space between. Now if we reload, now we can see that your entire parent div is being used up, but all these particular div elements, all these individual div elements, those are particularly maintaining a gap from each other which is equal in every case. You have used here justified content space between, you have used this flex basis 30%. Now if you have a look around, you can see that there are some properties, those are common, except that some of them are uncommon, such as this background property. Now this is another important CSS approach. Whenever you are creating a CSS, all you must ensure that all the common attributes, all the common properties, those should be written into a single place such that you do not have to repeat it yourself. But now if you see here, you can see that everything, those are getting repeated in every cases of child box 1, child box 2, child box 3, except this background color. Rest of these attributes or properties, those are common. So all we can do, first of all, copy this one, copy these things from here and paste it over here, and delete this rest of these things. With this approach, we can see that child box 1, child box 2, and child box 3, all of them are practically using these common attributes, which indicates a color assignment, a padding property assignment, a box sizing assignment, and flex basis assignment. In case of a block element or any kind of element, if you are using a padding, then all you need to do, you need to mention this thing box sizing, or you may do some manual calculation that how many space should be left after this or after that. So instead of that, I think using box sizing attribute is a very good option. Now we have used all of them into a single place, and the rest thing is background, which are different in every cases. So press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload, and now you can see that everything remains unaltered, nothing is changed. But the advantages of using this kind of CSS styling properties are, you don't have to repeat all of these properties again and again recurrently. That means you are getting free of error. So up to this part, I think it is now done. Get into index.html, comment this thing out. Reload, and now you can see there is a horizontal scroller. So in case of mobile responsiveness, there is a problem which is going on. We have to fix all these problems. That is why in this particular case, I'll be referring to use at the rate of media query. So here I'm calling this, I'll be copying this thing from here and I'll be pasting it here. Now I'm specifying a font size of, there you go, press Ctrl S, reload, and now you can see that it is now getting back in action. So we have successfully created this particular margin and padding thing. We have added some margin into our flexbox elements, and then we have made some kind of media query. And if you now see it into a larger one, we can see that every single block elements, they are maintaining practically an equal gap from both ends. So we have successfully placed them all along. That's it for today's tutorial. In the next tutorial, we are going to understand some more properties. So if you guys have liked this tutorial, then do not hesitate to hit the red subscribe button. Hope to see you guys in our next tutorial. Till then, bye.